Hello friends, today we will write a GUI application. So write a program to display selected image on left panel. Design the GUI using JSplit pane and JScroll pane. So we are going to design a graphical user interface. So I'll tell you how this looks like. Okay friends, we are going to design this particular GUI. So you can see this is a frame with the name Split Pane Demo. So the name of the frame is the split pane demo, and you can see there is a divider over here, and this frame is divided into two parts. That's what is the problem statement. The problem statement is asking us to use the split pane and divide the frame into two components. So on the left side component, we will be displaying the name of the images. And as soon as we click on a particular image name, then the image should appear on the right side division. Image names will be displayed by using the JList class. And on the right side, we will be displaying the concern image. In case if I say bird.gif, so this side, the bird image will be displayed. If I say cat, the cat image will be displayed. If I say dog, the dog image will be displayed. And see, you can see that the frame is having a title bar. So on the title bar, the title is displayed and it is having all the window options, the minimize, maximize and close option. So this is a frame, and you can see there is a divider over here. Width of this particular frame is 200, and I have set the divider in the middle, so which is at 200 pixels. And you can move the divider. So I can adjust this divider. By moving the divider, I can adjust the sizes of both the components, the left and the right components, friends. And see, one very important point over here is the minimum sizes of these two components, the left side component and the right side component, should be less than the entire frame size. Okay, so if the entire frame size is lesser than the sizes of these components, then this divider will not move for you. And you can see here, there is a triangle, up triangle, and there is a down triangle. This is called as the scroll bar. Okay, so the scroll bar will appear as needed. In case if there are so many names over here which are beyond the visible scope, a scroll pane is a component that presents a rectangular area in which a component may be viewed. There are vertical and horizontal scroll bars in an application. So your scroll panes are implemented in Swing by the JScroll pane class, which extends J component. There are four constants inside the scroll pane. The first one is the horizontal scroll bar always. Okay, and the second one is horizontal scroll bar as needed. So it will appear as needed. When you say always, it is by default there. And vertical scroll bar always, and vertical scroll bar as needed. So always provide the scroll bars. Okay, even if it is needed or not needed, it will be present. And here you can see I have provided the vertical scroll bar always. Okay, so that's why there is a scroll bar over here. But coming to the horizontal scroll bar, or as needed, so this will appear as needed. And even for this particular division also, there are scroll panes, but they will appear as needed. So this is the application that we are going to create. Before writing the program, let us just understand few points about Swing. Swing is a GUI widget toolkit for Java, and it is part of Oracle's Java Foundation classes, an API for providing a graphical user interface for Java programs. Swing was developed to provide a more sophisticated set of GUI components than the earlier AWT. It has more powerful and flexible components than AWT. Unlike AWT components, Swing components are not implemented by platform-specific code. Instead, they are written entirely in Java and therefore are platform-independent. In addition to familiar components such as buttons, checkboxes, and labels, Swing provides several advanced components such as tabbed panel, scroll panes, trees, tables, and lists. In December 2008, Sun Microsystems released the CSS FXML-based framework that it intended to be the successor to Swing called JavaFX. What is CSS? Cascading style sheets. And FXML is an XML based user interface markup language created by Oracle Corporation for defining the user interface of a JavaFX application. So there are two ways of creating a GUI application. One is by using AWT and the second approach is by using Swings. So Swings create, as you saw the differences, like Swing has got more components compared to AWT, and also the components are platform independent. So the application will look the same across all the platforms. And since AWT components are specific to the platform, the application may look different on different platforms. So by using Swings, you can create rich GUI applications. So let us create the application using Swing. Okay, well friends, so to write this program, so the procedure is like, first you have to create one file with the name imageNames.properties. So what does this file contains? This file contains the images is equal to bird.gif, cat.gif, dog.gif, and so on. What are all the images, list of image names that you want to show in the left side partition of the split pane? All that you will be writing over here. Okay. And the order of these names should match with the order of the images inside the image folder. Okay. So this is what will be there inside the imageNames.properties file. So this is the first thing you have to create. And the second one is create folder with images in it. Okay, so what are there in the imageNames properties? Bird, cat, and dog. So in the second step, you have to create a folder with images in it. This is the images folder, friends. And inside this images folder, I have placed the images. Okay, so the images are in the order of how they look in the image names properties file. So there bird is there first. So here also the image bird should be first, and then cat image, and then the dog image. And likewise, you can add whatever images you want. You can add over here. You can increase the names of the images, and also likewise you have to add the images also. I am just showing you a sample with the three images. You can also extend the number of images as you like. So have created the image names dot properties files and then the folder with images in it. Now you have to write the program, and the name of the program is splitpanedemo.java. So I'll walk you through the program, friends. So this is the program. Okay, first we'll see the import section. So import java.awt.star. So why did I import this package is for the window class. So I'm having a window class. So for the window class, I'm importing this. And awt.event.star, I am having a window listener. So for that, and window listener are event handling, so they will be found in java.awt.event package. So I am importing this package. Next is javax.swing package. So I am using jlabel, jlist, jsplitpane, and jframe. So all these will be found in javax.swing package. So I am importing this package. And next is javax.swing.event. So list selection listener is there, so which is there in javax.swing.event. And then java.util package. Java.util package I have imported for the vector class and also for the resource bundle class. So this is all about the import packages. And the next is the class description. So I said public class, and the name of the program or the name of the file and the name of the class both should be same, because it's a public class. So split pane demo implements list selection listener. So this list selection listener is there in javax.swing.event package. And whenever the user will be making changes in the selection of the list, like he selects or deselects an item from the list, then this list selection listener will be handling all those events. Okay. So herein I have declared certain reference variables for the vector class and jlabel and jlist and split pane. Okay, and first we'll go to the main method. So here is a main method, public static void main method. Inside the main method, I have created a frame. So you can see that here, friends. Okay, I said JFrame frame is equal to new JFrame, and the name of the frame is split pane demo, as I showed you in the beginning. So by doing, there are so many constructors of JFrame, but I have used the string title constructor of JFrame. And the title of the frame is split pane demo. And so here I said frame dot add window listener. So the window listener interface is in java.awt.event, and this interface has got 7 methods: window activated, window closed, window closing, window deactivated, window deiconified, window iconified, and window opened. I don't want all this, because if you are implementing an interface, then you have to implement all the methods, all the 7 methods. So I don't want to implement all these 7 methods. I just want window closing method. So to just use the window closing method, I have used the window adapter class. Adapter classes provide you the default implementations. So you can just override the method that you require, and you can ignore all the other 6 methods by using the window adapter class. So I just have used that. And also over here inside the window closing method, so I have written a code which says system.exit and 0. I have passed a 0 value here, which means that whenever the user is pressing the cross button, so it means it is a normal termination. Okay, so if it is abnormal, then you will be passing non-zero value, which will be other than 0. And since I'm passing 0, it means that it is normal termination. So it's a code indicates that it's normal termination. So this is regarding window listener. And then I'm saying split pane demo. So I'm calling the constructor. So we'll see what is there in the constructor. Okay, so this is the constructor, friends. Inside the constructor, now I have created a resource bundle, a reference variable, which is image resource. Now this, what is meant by this resource bundle class? This resource bundle class will load information from the properties file that contains the messages. Okay, so the resource bundle class will load the information that is there in the properties file. So the name of the properties file is image names. So I already have shown you the image names dot properties. So here in the name of the properties file is image names. So I have passed that. So this loads the image names over here, and then inside the image names dot properties, so you're having a message over here which says images is equal to. Okay, so now we want to extract only this message, which is bird gif, cat gif, and dog gif. We don't want this images is equal to, we just want the right side of this assignment operator. Okay, to extract that, I am using this. So I am saying string image names string is equal to image resource dot get string images. So images is the key over here. So what is this get string method? So this getString method is public final string getString. So this getString method will return a string for us, and the argument inside this getString method is the key. So whatever message matches with the key, that message will be stored in the image names string over here. So what is meant by a key? Here images is the key here. So images is equal to, so whatever matches, so the string key matches the images over here. So this bird.gf, cat.gf, dog.gf will now be stored in image names string. Okay, right. Now image names is equal to parse list image name string. So now we are calling the parse list method. So parse list method is a static method that I have written over here. So this method will be executed. So what happens inside this method? This method, we are creating a vector. So vector is in java.util package and implements the list interface. And vectors implements a dynamic array. That means that it grows or shrinks as required. It is just like the normal array that contains components that can be accessed using the integer indexes. Okay, so vector is similar to that. And here we are creating a vector which can hold the string type. And we are creating the size of the vector initially to be 10. And then we are here using the string tokenizer class, which will be tokening the string. Okay, so the tokens are obtained wherein the delimiter here between the tokens is a space. So if you see here, so between bird.gif and cat.gif, you can see there is a space here. Okay, and also between cat.gif and dog.gif, there is a space here. So now the token means the bird.gif is one token and cat.gif is another token and .gif is another token. So we are extracting the tokens, okay, by using the string tokenizer class. And then has more tokens to check whether more tokens are left out. If there are more tokens, then each and every token is taken and is kept in the string and then added into the vector. Okay, so finally the vector will be having bird.gif at 0 position, cat.gif at 1 and dog.gif at 2 position inside the vector. So after the parse list method is written, so the vector is now the image names. So we are putting this entire code in try and catch because the resource bundle will try to search for the image names properties file. Okay, path checking over here. So if it does not find the properties file in the specified path, then there will be an exception thrown. So that's why we have to put it in try and catch. And here I have used system.exit1. Why I have used this is because it's an abnormal termination. There is an exception and there is an abnormal termination. And next is create the list of names and put it in a scroll pane. So we are doing that. So I have created a JList. So this is a JList. The JList object. So here list is the JList object. The object of JList class represents a list of text items. The list of text items can be set up so that the user can choose either one item or multiple items. So that's the purpose of the JList. And inside the JList, we are creating a component. So this is a GUI component, swing GUI component. And we are creating it, and this list will be holding the names. What are those? Bird.gif, cat.gif, and dog.gif. All this will be there in the JList. And here we are setting the set selection mode, and we are saying list selection model dot single selection. So there are three selection modes. I am using single selection mode, wherein I can just select only one item from the list. And set selected index to be 0. So each and every item will be having an index value. So bird will be at 0. So the index value of bird will be 0, cat will be 1, and dog will be 2. And since this list we are selecting and deselecting, so obviously there need to be an interface which will listen. So we are adding list selection listener to the list. And we are adding a scroll pane to the list. Okay, so that I have done in this particular line. Okay, so I already told you what is meant by a scroll pane, right? And here I already told you about the four constants. So here I am setting the vertical scroll bar policy. And I'm saying vertical scroll bar always. That's the vertical scroll bar will be always present irrespective of whether the list is large or small. and next is set up the picture label and put it in the scroll pane. Now, so here we are taking the image icon class. The image icon class implements the icon interface that will be having the methods such as int get icon height, so which returns the height of the icon in pixels, and then int get icon width returns the width of the icon in pixels. And the constructors, there are two constructors of the image icon class. The first one will take a string file name and the second one will take the URL. So here is picture is equal to new J label, and we are passing this icon into the J label. String labels are instances of J label class, which extends J component. It can display text or an icon. So J labels can display a text or an icon. And the constructors of J label are, so J label icon I, okay, or J label string S icon and int align. So taken the constructor J label icon. So this will be displaying the icon. And picture dot set preferred size. Okay, so the size. Okay, so these are the methods. By using these methods, we are setting the size. And J scroll pane, we are adding the scroll pane to this particular label. We are splitting the frame. So to split the frame, we are using the split pane. So in this code, we are splitting the frame into two parts by using the split pane class. So using the J split pane dot horizontal split, you will be splitting the components left to right, and by using jSplitPane.VerticalSplit, you will be splitting the components top to bottom. So here I want a horizontal split, that is from left to right. So that's why I've used jSplitPane.HorizontalSplit. And then I am mentioning, okay, so what should be on the left side of the split pane and on the right side. So you can swap this. Okay, so here on the left side I am putting the list scroll pane and on the right side I am putting the picture. You can put it vice versa also. If you want the list to be on the right side, then you put picture here and the list here. Okay, so you can exchange them. So the order is like this. Okay, so whatever should be on the left side should be first. And then split pane dot set one touch expandable. So this one touch expandable is the divider that I'm talking about. So the divider, okay, so it is by default false. Now I'm setting it to true so that I can adjust it accordingly. Dot set divider location. So here I'm setting the divider location at 200. Wherein the split pane dimensions. So you can see at this particular line. So I'm setting the dimensions of the split pane and the dimensions of 400 and 200. The width is 400 pixels and the height is 200 pixels. And so I'm setting the divider in the middle. Okay, to set it, I'm half of 400 is 200. So I have set it in the middle over here. And then I'm setting the minimum size of the both the components. So the minimum size of the components is 150. Setting this minimum size to both the list and the picture. Okay, right. And so this is all what will happen in the constructor. So implemented list selection listener, right? So we have to override the method in this particular interface. So the method in this interface that we have to override is the value changed. So inside this value changed method, so there are certain if conditions. The first one is get value is adjusting. So this returns whether or not this is one in a series of multiple events where changes are still being made. If changes are still being made, we just have to wait. So that's the reason why we are saying return. And then we are asking to get the source. Okay, so get the source method will return the component which is the source of the event. So that will be returned over here. And this is selection empty. So is selection empty returns true if no indices are selected. So if no indices are selected, so this will return true. And then we are saying we are setting the picture to be null. else now once the selection is made, so we are getting the index. So if index value is there, so we are getting that in an integer, because index value is an integer. So we are taking an index which will hold the index value. And then we are saying, we are setting the icon. Okay, so the icon by selecting the path. Okay, so this is the URL. And then we are setting the icon, set icon, new image. And we are control return back to the main method after the call to the constructor. So now the split pane is added to the frame. How it is added? So it is added frame dot get content pane dot add. Now what is meant by get content pane? Get content pane method retrieves the content pane layer so that you can add an object to it. So this is like a layer. Okay, so the content pane is an object created by your Java runtime environment and which is used to hold the objects. Okay, so that's why we are calling it, and we have to add it onto this particular content pane. The split pane is added onto this particular content pane of the frame. And then we are saying frame.pack. Frame.pack pack method is defined in window class in Java and it sizes the frame. Okay, so this pack method is used to size the frame accordingly. And then we are saying frame.setVisible. By default, the frame is invisible. So you have to make it true, setVisible true, so that your frame will be visible. This is all that I have written in this code, friends. Okay. Now I'll execute the program and show it. These are the Viva questions. Please go through these questions. Thank you for watching.